Hello guys and welcome back to a new video. Today I have a great video for you. The Tesla Model 3 service interval, the maintenance schedule. I want to show you and I want to speak about the service in Tesla, in electric cars, and particularly in this Tesla Model 3. And I want to tell you how much you have to pay when you make the service, when you have to go to Tesla to service the car, and what you will have to change there when you go. And let's show you directly here, because you know the Tesla cars have this service book directly right here on the screen. And this was updated a few weeks ago, and I want to tell you and I want to speak about what maintenance cost it's in the Tesla Model 3. So this is the 2020 model, the brand new model, Tesla Model 3, but it doesn't matter because in all the Tesla Model 3, it is the same maintenance schedule and service interval. And Tesla here, if you read right here, those are the recommended service. So you don't have to go to the service every year like you're going to BMW or Mercedes or every other car manufacturer when you have to change the oil in the car. In this car you don't have any oil, you don't have any parts that need to be changed, like an oil filter or stuff like that. And then let me show you here the brake fluid health check every 2 years. So you have to check the brake fluid health every 2 years. Replace only if necessary. If you drive your car very slowly to work and home and you don't drive too much, probably you don't have to change the brake fluid every 2 years, but it's recommended to be checked. You know, on the older car, my older car, Audi A3 and Volkswagen, I never changed the brake fluid every 2 years, maybe every 4 years or something like that. Anyway, you have to change it, okay? There it say if the vehicle it's used for towing, replace the brake fluid every 2 years. So it's recommended that you replace the fluid if you're towing with the car. The air conditioning desiccate bag replacement every 6 years. Guys, this is crazy. Every 6 years you have to change the desiccate bag. The desiccate bag, it's a bag there inside somewhere where all the bacteria it's staying. Is not the filter itself. The filter, the cabin air filter, it's something else. So you don't have to be confused by those words, because the air filter is something else. It's right here under this somewhere. They can change it. You can change it every, not so easy. You have to open all that stuff around here and then you will find it there. But it's something else. It's a bag there, and I recommend it you to go to Tesla, but you have to do that every 6 years. So how cool is that? Then cabin air filter replacement every 2 years. So this is the cabin air filter that you can change it in every car in Tesla as well. So every 2 years you have to change this. Then you have to clean and lubricate the brake caliper every 20,000 kilometers. If in the area where the road are salted during the winter, for example in Canada, because Tesla sell a lot of cars in Canada, then you have to, there you have to change it for sure, and you have to clean and lubricate the caliper, the brake caliper, and you have to check it sometimes if everything is fine there. But I have to tell you guys, if you change your tires every year, for example, I keep my rims, these aero rims, all the time, and I have winter tires, I have summer tires, and when you go to change the winter tires with the summer tires, the people there, they will check out, they can check out your brake, they can check out your brake calipers, they can also clean it up in the same time. So you can do that almost two times a year if you change it like that. If you have your own rims, that's another story. Then you have to check it, yeah, like they say here, every 20,000, depend on every person. Then rotate tires, the same story as I told you before, rotate tires every 60 to 20,000 kilometer, or if tread deep difference it's 1.5 millimeter or greater. So what it say here, this is the last point. Here it say that you have to check the tires, the rotation of the tires. If you take big bumps, if you drive sporty, if you hit, for example, some bumps on the road and stuff like that, the rims will begin to be not so correctly aligned there, and the wheel will be like a little bit not on the right track, not rotated correctly. And then, but if you change the tires like I do every winter, every summer, then the guys there that change the tires, they will align with some aluminium. If you see my other video with changing tires, you will understand how they align the rims and the tires there, and they check that automatic. So I don't think this is something that you have to worry, but you have to keep in mind to check it out sometimes. Then let me go forward, guys, here, and let me tell you about the above interval are based on normal driving behaviors. So the Tesla tell you, if you drive normally, not something special like every day 200 kilometers or sporty driving on the track or stuff like that, then it's just on the normal behavior. So other than that, you have to check a little bit more often. Then it says here, additionally, the above list should not be considered comprehensive and does not include consumable parts such as windshield, wipers, brake pads, and etc. So yeah, that's something separate. Then the damage or failure caused by maintenance or repairing performance by non-Tesla certified technician are not covered by warranty. What that means? That means if you go to other service, not at Tesla, and you change the air filter, the cabin filter, sorry, because this car doesn't have an air filter, you change the cabin filter inside here at the other person, and something break when you change it and something doesn't work well, then the Tesla doesn't repair it on the warranty, so you have to pay for that. But if they do it right, if you change the cabin filter right and nothing happened, everything's fine, this is no problem. So the warranty, it's there, it's always there, no matter when you go to service. That's another thing that you have to keep in mind. The Tesla doesn't say you have to go every year or every 2 years in service to us because you lost your warranty or something like that. You don't have to pay. You have the warranty no matter when you go there. So that you have to keep in mind. That's something that never happened on other car manufacturers, from example BMW, Mercedes, Volvo, you have to Range Rover, Land Rover, everywhere you have to go there. If you don't go there, you lost your warranty, and then when you have to sell the car, will be a little bit more complicated. And yeah, anyway, you have to pay there a lot of money when you make the service on BMW and Mercedes. You have to keep this in mind. Let's go forward, guys. Daily check. So they recommend you also daily check for the people that, yeah, they don't have, maybe they are new with cars, or maybe they don't know so much. Then check the battery charge level. So for example, here you have to charge the battery charge level, check the condition pressure of the tires, then check that all exterior light, horn, turn signal, wipers, washers, check for any unexpected indicator light or vehicle alert. For example, you have up here all the alert, all the problems that car have, it will appear up here or sometimes here, depend on what the error is. And then check the operational brake, the parking brake, if it's working, check the seat belt, and look for anormal fluid deposit underneath model 3 that might indicate a leak. It's normal for a small pool of water to form, then caused by the air conditioning system, deshumidificator processing. So really interesting. So yeah, you have to check under the car if it's something leaking or some problem under the car. You have to check and look sometimes every day, they say, but yeah, you have to look it. Look around the exterior of the model 3 of your car and immediately remove the corrosive substance, as the bird dropping, tree resid, tar spot, dead insects, industrial foes, and etc. So what they say, Tesla, here, you have to wash your car more often because this is a new thing here, because the people have a lot of problem with the paint, so you have to check your car paint and around the car, and you have to wash it all the time, and you don't have to leave all kind of debris on the car that can eat your paint and make rust in time. So anyway, you have to check it. Then monthly check, what you have to do here on the monthly check, you have to check the windshield water fluid level and top up. So you put the water on the windshield, that's normal, everybody do that. Check the air conditioning system if operate correctly. So anyway, you check it because you have to open it. If it's something immediately notice, you have to check to go to Tesla. If you see that the fluid level on the own wheel tire wheel, so the tires are not correctly aligned there, for example, when the geometry of the tires is not right, for example, you know, sometimes you have to go to make the geometry of the car, and when the tires it's not right on the track, it will wear on the right, on the left, more than in the middle, more than on the other side, and then you have to change the tires very fast, and this is not good. You have to check it sometimes, the tires. Then the fluid, look guys, this is, I think this is the most important thing, that on the first Teslas, on the Tesla Model S, the first one, I think until 2015, I think 2015 or 2016, all the Tesla cars have to be changed the coolant in the battery. You know, the battery has an interesting system that cool down the battery, you know, it's a fluid that go around the battery, and when it's hot, it will cool the battery, and that fluid will have to be replaced every 4 years. But now in the Tesla Model 3, the new one, you don't have to change that fluid. Never have to change that fluid. How cool is that? So let me show you, it's right here on the paper, it's not something that I say. Fluid replacement interval, your battery coolant does not need to be replaced for the life of your vehicle under most circumstance. Brake fluid should be checked every 2 years, replace if necessary. So how cool is that? No replacement for the coolant in the battery. So great news. If the vehicle it's used for towing, something that we see before, you have to change the brake fluid every 2 years. Any damage caused by opening the battery coolant reservoir, it's excluded from the warranty. So guys, never open the battery coolant reservoir. Don't open it, because you never have to change that coolant. Anyway, why would you do that? High voltage safety, here it's other cool interesting stuff that tell you that the Model 3 is designed to build for safety as a priority. However, be aware of the precaution to protect yourself from the risk of injury in all system with high voltage. So here it say that you don't have to open the voltage or put your hands there, or for example, if you have an accident, you don't have to touch any wires or high voltage connectors and all that stuff. So avoid to be there. So yeah, I think that's all. Here are some warnings. For example, always disconnect the charging cable before working underneath the car, then keep your hands and clothes away from the cooling fans. Some fans operate even when the Model 3 is up. And then some fluid and battery acid, coolant, brake fluid, windshield, blah blah blah, using the vehicle poison, and he can poison you and stuff like that. So anyway, I think this is really interesting. The service on the Tesla Model 3, it's very very cheap. I think it's close to zero. I think I have to go to check out this car in 2 years. After 2 years I have to go there and check out, only if I need to change the brake fluid. Probably not, probably I will change it in 4 years. I will change the cabin air filter for sure in 2 years. I don't know. Yeah, in 2 years I will change it, because here the air in my area, the air is really clean and it's not so much dust. So I change it in 2 years. And of course I check my tires every year, because I have to change the winter tires with the summer tires, and they will check it. They will rotate it. They will check that. So that's not a problem. And yeah, I don't know. I hope I will don't have any error until then. I have the car 2 months now and I don't have any problem with the car, any error. One time was a small error and I reset the screen and then it was work perfectly. So I'm really happy with the car. I'm happy that I don't have to pay for any service and oil and all that stuff. All I have to pay is change the tires and then things like that. So guys, I hope you enjoyed. I hope you enjoyed my video with those information about the Tesla Model 3 service. Also, I'm in Europe, so I think in USA and all over the world is the same rules. Thank you for watching. By the way, if you want to buy a Tesla car or Model 3 or a Tesla, you can use my referral code. You find it down under the video. And you will get 1,500 kilometers for free supercharging. I think this is a bonus for both of us. And anyway, thank you. I hope it was helpful for you guys. Check out my other videos. I have plenty of other videos with cars and also with Model 3. If you're interested in what kind of things I made to my car, accessories, I changed the tires, what kind of winter tires I have, and all kind of stuff around the car. So thank you for watching. See you in the next video, and bye guys. Stay safe, drive safe, and see you soon.